Hey friends, it's Devin here with Make Anything, and today it's my pleasure to present my latest puzzle. This is my contribution to the Puzzle Advent Calendar, which is an annual collaboration between YouTubers and puzzle creators where we share brand new puzzles every day of the month leading up to Christmas. Today is day 9, and in front of me are a few versions of what I call the Force Field Puzzle. The reason I'm blindfolded is that this puzzle is designed to be solved purely by feel. One of my favorite 3D printing YouTube channels is Filament Stories, where Courtney shares some of the coolest and craziest new filaments on the market, while also showcasing all kinds of great models from various designers. And it's just a fantastic channel. I highly recommend you subscribe if you haven't already. Every now and then, Courtney's daughter Reese will jump behind the camera, and somehow Reese manages to match her mom's infectious enthusiasm and positivity, and it's just always a joy to watch. Reese also happens to be blind, so that inspired me to create a puzzle with her in mind. As it turns out, it was also her birthday last month, so I was able to send her the first copies of these force field puzzles, and she tested them out on my behalf.
It's a puzzle. I think I got it. So what I did is I figured out where the magnets were, and then I stuck them together. And half of the time they were bouncing against me like, nope, I'm not going together. You can't make me. And the other half of the time they were like, okay, I'll go this way.
All right, are you gonna start on the next one?
I think I want to, but also I'm not sure because you said I'm probably gonna pull my hair out.
Reese absolutely crushed it. She solved the puzzle and that was super cool. So I figured it's only fair that I try to solve it blind as well. Now, the idea with this version in front of me is that we have 8 pieces that will assemble to form a 2x2 cube. And all the inside faces of these pieces have magnets that either attract or repel each other. And the idea is to use that magnetic force to guide the assembly of this puzzle. So I'm gonna go ahead and keep this blindfold on until this puzzle is solved. And we're gonna see if I can complete it in the amount of time it takes me to explain how I designed and constructed this puzzle. Starting now. Oftentimes, ideas like this come to me in the middle of the night while I'm trying to sleep, and I have to jump out of bed and sketch them out so I don't forget. It's pretty inconvenient, but hey, at least I have ideas. After figuring that this puzzle may work, I jumped right into Fusion 360 to model out the parts. And the shapes are pretty simple, so the trickiest part was just keeping track of all the ways that the magnets would be facing. To do that, I modeled some placeholders that are color coordinated to represent the poles of the magnets, and I made sure to use every possible configuration of magnets, so this puzzle is as challenging as possible for the number of magnets that they use. I hid the assembly instructions inside of these magnet holes with a little extra cutout to differentiate one magnet direction from the other. That way, it's easy to assemble without giving away the solution once it's all done. The parts print really easily without supports, and they're randomly oriented to avoid giving away the solution based on that as well. I always use my cheapest filaments for the first prototype, so this isn't the cleanest print, but we can still see the magnet indications inside of the holes, so I'll start gluing the magnets in using E6000 adhesive. It's really important to keep track of how you glue the magnets in because once it's done, there's no easy way to confirm that they're correct. So my strategy is to glue in all the magnets for one orientation, and once those are completely cured, I can glue in the opposing magnets. Also, since the magnets may want to push each other out, I found that using scotch tape works well for holding them in place while they cure. I also printed these optional covers that can be glued over the faces, so the magnets are completely hidden and held in place. And that's about it. I did find that the cheap magnets I used for the first print were a bit too weak for my taste, so I would encourage using proper N52 grade magnets for this puzzle, and I'll link to some good ones in the video description. Whew! All right, I did it. as you can see, all these pieces really want to stick together. So that means this 2x2 cube is solved. And I think I might have got a bit lucky that time. That was pretty quick. If you want to gain some empathy for the visually impaired, I suggest you also try solving this puzzle blindfolded, because while it doesn't require sight, solving a puzzle blindfolded is something most of us aren't used to. It's quite an experience. Now, since there are a lot of puzzle masters out there, I knew that this 2x2 wouldn't satisfy everyone, so I went ahead and designed some more challenging versions of this force field puzzle as well. So here's one of my earlier prototypes, which is also a 2x2, but it has magnets on all of the faces. So that means there's a lot of other possibilities for arranging these cubes that are incorrect. So I think it's a bit harder to solve. And then to step it up another level, I created this wireframe cube. I printed this super colorful just for fun, but of course, the colors provide no assistance when it comes to solving this puzzle. Again, it's done purely by feeling the magnetic attractions. I sent Reese this version as well, and she still managed to solve it in no time at all.
Yes, I got it! I know I have it right because the magnets don't push away from each other, and the middle pieces spin when they're attached right like this, but they don't come apart. Devin, thank you so much for these amazing puzzles. I don't have a lot of puzzles that I can do as a blind person, so they were really fun, and I loved them. Thank you for the unusual birthday present.
Very impressive, Reese. I just might have to send you my most challenging version of this puzzle so far, which is this solid 3x3 cube. This one has a whopping 27 pieces, as well as the fewest number of unique solutions, so it's a real step up, and sure to be a challenge for even the wildest puzzlers out there. To be honest, I kept track of all the filaments I used to print the different pieces here so that I could assemble it, referencing my original model. Otherwise, I never would have gotten this video out on time. I actually made the wireframe version after designing this solid 3x3, because I noticed with all of these magnets attracting each other, if there's one that isn't working, sometimes it's hard to tell that they're not correctly in place, but if you kind of pull the sections apart one by one, you should be able to check whether you've correctly assembled this puzzle. Anyways, those are my force field puzzles, and you can download them now at thangs.com, so go ahead, give them a shot. And if some of you think this is still too easy for you, just let me know and maybe I'll design an even more intense version of this puzzle. But that's it for day 9 of the puzzle advent calendar. I'll put links in the description for the full playlist so you can see all the other cool puzzles coming out this month. And I'll also link to Filament Stories. Thank you so much to the Filament Stories family for participating in this video. That was a pleasure. And thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video. And until then, take care and stay inspired.